This video is going to be about dividing a polynomial by a polynomial, and we're going to use a method called algebraic long division. So here's the first example. I've got 3x squared minus 5x minus 7, and that's being divided by another polynomial, in this case a binomial, x minus 3. And because this is not a monomial, I can't do anything as simple as dividing this into three fractions. What I've got to do is set this up like a long division problem that you may have learned when you were first learning long division in elementary school. So I'm going to take the divisor, the denominator, and write x minus 3. And then I'm going to make one of these division boxes. And in that, I'll put in my numerator, 3x squared minus 5x minus 7. And now I'll begin my process. So I'm going to take the first term here, the x, and divide it into this first term, 3x squared. So x divided into 3x squared is the same as saying, let's do that over here, 3x squared over x. And that's going to reduce to just 3x. Okay, because I'm taking the 1, the exponent in the denominator, subtracting it from the exponent in the numerator, that would just give me 3x. Now, I'm going to write the 3x over the x term that I have here. And now, as in regular long division, I'm going to take this 3x and multiply it by the divisor. So in effect, I'm going to distribute 3x across x minus 3. So 3x times x is going to be 3x squared. And this is a good time to check your work. These two numbers, these two terms, should be exactly the same. If they're not, go back and find out where you made a mistake. Then I'm going to take the 3x and multiply it by negative 3, and that'll give me a negative 9x. And then, as in regular long division, I'm going to subtract this number from the number above it. Now, here's where you have to be careful. We're subtracting signed numbers. In other words, we're subtracting a negative. So let's see what happens. Well, first we take the 3x squared and subtract 3x squared. That's fine. That leaves us with 0. And we want to get rid of both. We want to eliminate both these numbers. Then we're taking negative 5x and subtracting negative 9x. Well, subtracting a negative is the same as adding. So it's going to be as if we have negative 5x plus 9x. Negative 5 plus 9 will be a positive number. It'll be positive 4. And it's positive 4x. Now, as in regular long division, I'm going to bring down my next number, or my next term. So this is 4x minus 7. And I'm going to divide that by the first term here. I'm going to divide the x, the first term, into the first term down here. So x divided into 4x, which is the same as saying 4x over x. The x's will cancel, and I'll just have a 4. So this is going to be plus 4. And then I multiply 4 times the whole divisor. I distribute it. So 4 times x is 4x. These are both the same. That's good. 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. And then I'm going to subtract that. So subtracting, 4x minus 4x is 0. Negative 7 minus negative 12. Negative 7 minus a negative is the same as negative 7 plus 12. So negative 7 plus 12 is 5. This is my remainder. What we do with the remainder is we add it to the answer here as a fraction. So I'm going to get 5 over the divisor, x minus 3. That's going to be my answer. Okay, so let's do another one. and make sure that you understand this pattern. So here we have 2x squared minus 10 divided by x plus 2. So I'm going to take my x plus 2 and put it here. And now I have to be careful. You notice I have an x squared, but I don't have an x. Now, if there's a term missing, in other words, if I look at this first term, which has an exponent of 2, I want to have another term with an exponent of 1, and then some constant. But I don't have an x. So what I'm going to do is write 2x squared plus 0x. And you'll see in a second why I want to do that. Minus 10. And now I'm going to do this problem just like the other one. So I take this first term, this x, and divide it into this first term, 2x squared. That's going to give me a 2x. I multiply 2x times x plus 2. So 2x times x is 2x squared. They're both the same. That makes me happy. Then I've got 2x times 2. That will be plus 4x. And I'm going to subtract. So 2x squared minus 2x squared is 0. And then I've got 0x minus 4x. And see, I needed this 0x so I could subtract the 4x from something. So 0x minus 4x is just negative 4x. I bring down the next number, which is negative 10, also the next term, and I begin again. X divided into negative 4x is just negative 4. 4 times x, negative 4 times x, is negative 4x. Negative 4 times 2 is negative 8. I'm going to subtract. Negative 4x minus negative 4x will be 0. Negative 10 minus negative 8. Minus negative 8 is the same as plus 8. So I've got negative 10 plus 8. That gives me a negative 2. And I'm going to take this negative 2 and use it, since it's my remainder, use it as a fraction up here. So I'll put my negative sign in right here. And then I've got 2 over x plus 2. Okay, so let's go over the steps again. First of all, if you're missing a term when you have terms where the exponents should be in descending order, add in a zero term. Then take the first term in your divisor, divide it into the first term that you see here. You take whatever you get, write it up here where your answer is going to go. Then multiply that answer, that 2x, times the whole divisor. You're distributing it. Then subtract. This is the most dangerous part. Be careful when you subtract because you're dealing with different signs. After you've subtracted, bring down the next term. Start your process again. Take this first term in the divisor, divide it into the first term you see down here, write your answer up here, take that answer, and distribute it across the whole divisor. Subtract again. Keep doing this until there's nothing more to bring down, and then take whatever remainder you have, use that remainder as the numerator of a fraction where the denominator is going to be your divisor. Okay, that's it. Something nice about these, which I'll cover in a different video, is there's a way to check them. So I'll show you that in an extra video, but that's about all the time we have for this right now. Okay, see you next time.